everyone, and welcome to the Evan Carmichael Show. I am your host, Evan Carmichael. I believe that hungry entrepreneurs deserve help. So today, I'm talking to you about your business. I've got a really exciting show lined up today, but first, I need to warn you. I was out really late last night. I was hosting a dance party with one of the companies that I'm an investor in. And so today, I'm running on fumes, but I went to my local coffee shop. I picked up an iced cappuccino that I'm drinking throughout the show. So I'm excited because there's a lot of great content that I want to get through. Here's what I'm talking about today. I'm talking about how to be opportunistic, how to get more referrals, how to make money on Fiverr.com. And I have a special guest, Mark Mason, who's joining me, who's bought a house from the money he made on Fiverr, and how to make $1 million, answering that million-dollar question. It is important that you are opportunistic with your business. You have to chase down the opportunities ahead of you. Otherwise, you're going to end up living a life full of regret that you never took your shot. My family likes to call me an aggressive driver, and I prefer the word opportunistic. Now, I'll be careful because I know my mom is listening to the show. Hi, Mom. I drove safely to work today. I'm not going to be the guy who's tailgating you, who is flashing his lights at you, who's honking his horn at you. I'm not that driver. But if I see a chance to get ahead by cutting into the next lane, then you can bet your bottom dollar that I am going to take it. And you need the same approach with your business. You have to be opportunistic. You have to chase down those opportunities. There's two major problems with a lot of entrepreneurs. The first are the wannabe entrepreneurs. These are the guys who have a great idea, but they're stuck in a corporate job, and they're too afraid to take their shot. Here's what's going to happen. You're going to watch somebody else make big dollars off of your idea while you wish that you went for it. When you're older and you look back on your life, you're not going to say to yourself, I wish I took fewer chances. If you have a great idea, if there's a great opportunity in front of you, you have to go for it. You've got to do something today and start taking action. You can't be afraid. The second kind of entrepreneur are the ones who are running their business. You're doing your business. You're taking your shot. You're trying to make it work. But you're so busy doing the day-to-day work, doing the paperwork, putting out fires, handling all the crap that you have to do in your business. You're so buried in your company that you're missing out on the big opportunities to take your company forward. Every time I've had a growth in my business, a major leap forward, it's because I took off the things on my plate that were tying up my time. You have to make room for what I call CEO time. You need to have that built into your day to help you focus on your growth. Think about when you get the best ideas for your company. When do you get your best ideas? Are they when you're stressed out, overworked, coming home and having barely any time to sleep, not eating well, not taking care of yourself? Is that when you get your best ideas? Or is it when you're relaxed? When you go on vacation? When you're having a shower? When you're playing sports or taking a walk? You have to make sure you free up your time. You have an opportunity to grow. And I know what you're thinking. Hey, I'm busy. Running a business is hard work. I don't have time to do that. Nobody's going to get this stuff done if I don't do it. And you know what? You're right. I know running a business is hard. It's one of the hardest things you're ever going to do in your life. But here's the problem. Here's the truth. If you don't make time for that CEO time, if you don't put the hours in to focus on the growth of your business, you are constantly going to be running on that treadmill, running, trying to get further ahead and not moving anywhere. You're going to hit a plateau, and you're not going to know how to bust through it. And you're going to start to hate your business and hate your life. You need to make sure you plan that CEO time into your day, into your weeks, into your months, and that you're relaxed and not too stressed out and overworked, so that when an opportunity comes to you, you have the capacity to jump on it. You're not just doing the same thing over and over and over again and not seen any growth with your business. Let's get to the calls. We have Kiki on the line. Kiki, where are you from and how can I help?
I'm from Memphis, Tennessee.
Welcome to the program. What's going on?
I actually have an idea. I mean, I live like I actually wanted to open up like a laundromat.
Okay.
And just didn't know how to go about trying to do that, whether I should ask for a business loan or try to find a grant that would support me.
Why do you want to do a laundromat?
I just feel like it would probably be, you know, easier to run, I'm thinking. I don't know.
That's okay. Hey, you know what? You're at the very early stages of running the business, and it's great to explore your options. The thing is, if you want to have a lot of success as an entrepreneur, you have to build a business around something that you passionately believe in.
Right.
And that you love doing. So
right.
Maybe you love laundry. Hey, I'm not judging. But it doesn't sound like that's something that really, you know, pulls at your heartstrings.
Right.
If you're in a business just trying to make money, you're usually not going to. Is there something else that you can do? Something, a passion you're really excited about that maybe you could turn into a business?
Fashion. I like designing.
Designing, okay. Have you done anything? Have you helped people with their designing their clothes or designing? What do you design?
I'm thinking about getting a certain software that, you know, kind of helps you design, you know, clothes. I'm thinking about starting there.
Okay.
Then maybe, making some pieces and wearing them and showcasing them like that.
That's a great start. Do you know anybody who needs some clothes as well that you might be able to help them out with?
Yes. A lot of people.
Why are you laughing?
It's a lot of people that need help.
Okay. Is that something you would enjoy doing?
Yes. I love clothes. I love designing. I love shopping and, you know, I love that.
So why would you pick a laundromat over this?
I'm just looking at it as a way for me to get started, to build on something that I really want to do.
Right. So my suggestion would be to start right in with something that you're passionate about. Because the laundromat is still going to be a ton of work.
Yeah.
It's going to be work that you don't enjoy doing.
Right.
And if you started the business around something you're excited about, like fashion, you make your own clothes, it's going to be fun. You can help people out who have fashion issues as well.
Right, yeah.
And you'll have fun. Yeah. Like when you're helping people, you have fun, it gives you energy, but it can also make you a lot of money.
Right.
What's your next step? What's your next step to making that dream happen?
Like I said, just showcasing it, you know, by wearing it and people saying, oh, I like that, and, you know, kind of like a word of mouth thing, and maybe getting it, you know, hopefully getting into some stores, maybe.
What can you do this week to get started on it?
Actually, like I said, start with the design and try to put together some actually sewing a couple of, well, not a couple of pieces, but a piece.
Okay. Are you going to do it?
Yes.
Are you excited?
Yes, I am. Yes.
All right, good. Hey, listen, I'm here every 2 weeks. Call back and let me know how you're progressing along, because I want to see this business take off for you.
Okay, I will do that.
All right. Thank you so much, Kiki. Good luck.
Thanks for having me on.
All right. So for all of you listening, you know, I know what you're thinking. You want to make money. You want to jump in on something that can make you some short-term cash, but those things rarely work out. You're going to get frustrated. You're going to lose your money. You're going to hate your business and your life. You have to find and build a business around something that you are intensely passionate about, brings you joy, and you know is going to help a lot of people. Start with that. Even if it's part-time, even if it's just getting started, it doesn't have to be full-time hours, do something that you love. You'll feel the energy from doing it. when you're helping people, you're going to love it. You're going to start making money, and you can fuel that success to help you keep going. If you want to grow your business, you need to get referrals. Referred customers buy more from you, are more loyal. They refer new business to you. You have to build your business around it. A small business that doesn't have referrals is dead in the water. And the way to go out and do it is to support your network. Don't wait, sit in your chair for business to come to you. You got to go out there, stay top of mind, make sure people remember you, and will pass your name on. Recently, a person on my newsletter wrote in and said, Evan, I need help with my social media strategy. I need somebody to help me train on it. And I wrote back to say, hey, you know what? I have a worksheet that can help you. It's $7, tons of value, but it's a worksheet. You know, I'm not going to do one-on-one. That's not my business. But I have a friend who does that. His name is Sean Moffitt. He's also a host on this radio station. And so I called up Sean, and I made a video doing this. So I started filming my video. I mic'd myself up. I called up Sean. He answered. I said, Sean, okay, first, before we get started, you are on camera. I'm filming you, so don't say anything you're going to regret. You guys can watch this video up on YouTube today. And I told him about this opportunity, and he said it was great, thank you so much, and I gave him the chance to also talk about his business. So what's happening here? The woman who wrote into me is getting help. I'm not getting paid from it, but I'm helping her out. John, who's in my network, I'm giving him a lead. And I'm also giving him exposure on the radio show today now, talking about the story, on my YouTube channel and on my website. And the people who are watching the video also get the benefit as well. I'm sending out massive karma, and it's going to come back to help me. I'm not a huge fan of going up to people and saying, hey, can you refer somebody to me? Because it puts them on the spot and makes them feel awkward. But if you find ways to stay top of mind, support your network, you're going to get referrals coming to you. And I know what you're thinking. This is hard. You know, I don't have the time to do this. I'm running my business. That takes a lot of time. You know what? It does. It's true. But I guarantee you, you're doing things on your sales and marketing side that are not working. And this is something that works. This is critical to your business. You have to do it. And it's also fun. When you're reaching out to your network and you're helping them, you're not only going to give them business and they're going to give you business back, you're going to get new ideas and opportunities come to you by staying connected. People are busy. You have to stay top of mind. But don't sit back and wait for things to happen. Go out and proactively find ways to support the people in your network. Give them business. Give them testimonials. Give them ideas. Stay in touch. Help them out, and they'll help you out. I have IJ on the line. IJ, what is going on? Where are you from, and how can I help?
Okay, I'm from West Palm Beach, Florida.
Okay.
I have a business. I make wigs for cancer patients, and I make wigs for people with fashion. I spoke to you guys about marketing my business.
Okay.
Last month.
Sorry, I didn't get what you do. You make wheat?
Yeah, wigs for the cancer patient,
wigs.
For the chemotherapy.
Got it. Okay,
yeah.
Got it. Okay, perfect. And you're trying to figure out how to market your business?
Yes. I spoke to you guys a month on the 14th or 15th, between that period. I spoke to you guys. You guys told me how to market my business. I should go to the cancer hospital. So I went there and marketed my business. Since then, I spoke to you guys. The encouragement you guys give me,
okay.
My business.
Well,
but
that's great that you got some advice. Who are you partnering up with to get this business?
Nobody. Going? Nobody. So
nobody.
Just
why not?
Yeah.
How come?
So I went to Korea to learn how to make a wig.
Okay.
So when I came back, my husband opened a wig shop for me. So I started designing it.
Okay.
So it was so slow. I don't know how to market it. But later...
You have your own store?
Yes.
Okay. And the people who are coming in are typically what kind of clients?
Regular people, not people that I really wanted. People who doesn't... You know, they just came and look and they go back.
What kind of problems are they facing? Is it usually
the problem is the money. They can't afford to buy the wig because it's expensive here.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the problem. So I don't know how to get the richer client that they will know that this is, you know, a good wig shop.
How do you promote your shop? What's your sales pitch?
My percentage?
Yeah. What's your sales pitch?
like in a day, I can make a thousand, 2,000, depends how the people come in.
No, I mean, how do you sell it? So if I was coming
from 1,500 upwards, 1,500 upwards.
So I'm not asking about the price. I want you to sell me. So I'm a customer walking in. I'm an older guy. I'm balding. I'm thinking about a wig. What are you going to tell me? Why are you so great? Why should I spend money with you?
I'll give you welcome. I said, welcome. This is a good wig. I bring out the wig. I said, this is a human hair, 100% human hair, natural.
Okay.
Then you ask me a question.
Hold on, that's not enough, though. You gotta sell me. Like, a lot of people have natural human hair wigs, right? That's not something that's differentiating you from other people. What's special about your wigs that nobody else does?
Because it's different. I go to your scalp and I measure your hair follicle, or all the problem you have, where you want to put it. I put it to you, and I file it for you. I cut it. I color it. I do everything.
But nobody else does that?
No, nobody else do that except you went to a salon to do the coloring.
This is what you need to use in your pitch. The problem may not be that people don't have the money. They may not know fully what you're offering. For people to understand why they need to buy a wig from you versus everybody else, they need to know what makes you different. Just saying human hair, it's not enough. So in your pitch, you have to talk about all the things that make you different and special and unique, and why they need to buy from you over everybody else.
Yeah. I did it there. I make it there right away for you. You just see the way I show you how the wig get made. I show you everything, and you know.
Yeah, that has to be built into your pitch. When you're talking to people, when they say, hi, I'm interested in a wig, that all has to come out. So just saying human hair, it's not enough, right? You have to say why you're different, because they're probably not just going to go to you. They're going to go to other wig stores, too, and compare. So you have to win that business, and it's going to be from saying, hey, this is a quality product. We have a unique process that helps you, and you explain it. The only way to get this done, this is the only one doing it in America.
Yeah.
You have to go to Asia otherwise to get it done.
Okay.
That's different.
Yes, you're right.
Yeah?
Oh. Yeah, that is a very good idea. Yes, you're right.
Okay, good luck. Hey, I'm on every 2 weeks. If you want to call back with another question, let me know how you're doing. I'll be here, okay?
All right, thank you very much. Ooh, I like that. Thank you.
Thanks for calling in. Take care.
Bye.
So for everybody who's in the industry, hey, when people say, what do you do? It's got to make sense. You've got to have something that makes it easy for people to learn about your business, but also share it. Fiverr.com, that's Fiverr.com, is a website that I signed up for about a year ago, and it's where people buy and sell mostly services for $5 at a time. I've done a little bit on the site. I've bought and sold a little bit, and I came across one of the Fiverr members. His name is a narco fighter on Fiverr. His real name is Mark Mason, and I discovered that he bought a house from the proceeds he made as a seller on Fiverr, and so I've invited him to join as a guest today to talk about his success and introduce it to you guys. Mark, how are you doing?
I'm doing awesome. Hello, Mr. Evan Carmichael. So good to be here and help the entrepreneurial listeners really make a transformation in their business that'll make a huge difference.
That's awesome. Welcome to the program. Now, for my audience, who many of whom have no idea what Fiverr is, could you give a quick intro?
Sure, absolutely. And the best way to understand Fiverr is to realize it's like other experiences that they will instantly understand as soon as I just say the URL, because it's a marketplace. It's sort of taking what I like to call the worldwide wild west of the internet and taming it a little bit and making it a place where buyers and sellers can congregate and do so in a much more orderly fashion. You know, there's been the pioneering is over and the settlers have started. And the example I would use is like eBay. We understand when you go to eBay that there's going to be, and at eBay primarily, things, right, Mr. Carmichael? There's things at eBay that are for sale and there are vendors selling it. And as we've watched the transformation of eBay from the day when it was first selling used lipstick containers to what it is today, there are stores, there are complete enterprises taking place in that marketplace. Well, Fiverr is essentially like being able to be a part of something like eBay at this point now when it was just 3 years old, because that's what Fiverr is. It came three in I think, April or so, March or April. And so it's a young marketplace, but it has taken and tamed the world wild web, if you will, and made it so that we as entrepreneurs who just want to be about transacting our services, not about becoming experts in internet marketing, to do so effectively.
Okay, so Mark, a lot of my listeners are going to be thinking, you know what, I'm so busy running my company, I can barely keep up on my website and my blog and social media. Why should they care? Why should they log into Fiverr and open an account? Why should they care about this?
Well, you nailed the right question. The first thing to do, without a doubt, is to open an account. And here's the number one reason why. Because one of the very best ways to expand your business, perhaps even to get out of that sense of a rat race of doing all of these tasks that you know are important, are occasionally even urgent, but often are quite consuming of your time. One of the very first things to do on Fiverr is to open an account and then become a buyer, become a shopper, learn the lay of the land. Since this is somebody else's marketplace and we're sort of going into their home, learn what it looks like, learn how it works. And my suggestion would be to go ahead and buy back some of your time by taking some of those activities. Maybe you hire somebody to write a blog post for you. Maybe you hire somebody to go get some additional links or likes or friends on your social networking site. Or maybe simply to go ahead and follow up with birthday messages when they pop up on Skype. So the first thing to do is to buy back that time so that there's more time to do the things in your business which are not only important and essential, but frankly lead to revenue, right?
Now, okay, so how do you go from making $5 a sale to buying a house? How does that happen for you?
Well, the reason that it happens is because $5 is the starting point. It's not the ending point. See, Fiverr in itself describes as the largest marketplace for services starting at $5. But by simply participating in the marketplace, you're rewarded for your performance. Once you've had an account that is at least 30 days old and you've made 10 successful sales, then you're ranked a level one seller. And at that point, you're no longer limited to a merely $5 offer. It can now be as much as a $45 offer. Well, as you may guess, Mr. Carmichael, I am at the highest rank that Fiverr offers. You can't even just earn this one. It's honorary. You have to be awarded it. It's called the top-rated seller. There is a level in between called level two, which you can earn merely by performance. It's automatic. It will happen as long as you're a good Fiverr citizen and sell at least 50 completed orders in a 60-day period of time. But at the top-rated seller level, I am able to turn $5 sales into $500 sales. And as you can imagine, with making, you know, several sales a day, many of which move right through what I call my Fiverr funnel, and that really is, if I can say, the ABC of Fiverr for me. The ABC of Fiverr is A, account, make your account. B, buyer, become a buyer, learn the lay of the land, buy back some extra time for yourself, and then finally C, craft an offer. And you're going to craft an offer initially just to get those levels happening. And then as you level up, you're going to recraft your offer and create your Fiverr funnel, the method by which you take $5 sales into $50 sales and ultimately into $500 sales.
Got it. So as you get more experience and you move up, you can upsell your customers along the way.
Exactly.
Now, what do you sell? What's your best-selling product right now or service?
Sure. My best-selling product or service is on, interestingly, how to get publicity, how to be having what's happening right now between you and I. That is my number one selling gig, has thousands of fans, sells, you know, many units a day, and has a complete Fiverr funnel built into it.
So walk me through what that looks like. What do I get for $5, $50, $500 for you?
Absolutely. And let me say, you know, this is my approach to Fiverr, so I want to own that. There are other approaches that people take, and they're also successful. This is just works for me because I have an information marketing background. So for $5, and this is, I think, important to point out because your entrepreneurs may also be saying, look, I'm not so sure, Mark, I'm not so sure, Evan, that there's anything I'd be willing to do for just $5, right? And so for me, the thing I'm willing to do, quote unquote, is to have a file be uploaded, just like it delivered in as automated a fashion as possible. And so for $5, somebody gets the Media Insider Secret Report. If they visit Fiverr.com/anarcho-fighter, they can actually see this offer. It's one of the featured offers. Fiverr has picked it for special recognition. And if they were to order that for $5, they would find out what I learned as being in the media world as a journalist about how people can get surefire access to getting publicity rather than being like the 3 out of 4 people who never get the publicity even if they try. So it's a psychological and historical opening and understanding on how to get free publicity for your business. Now, right off the bat, when somebody makes that purchase decision, they're given an option to order custom ideas for their business. That has a higher price tag. In addition to that, they're offered a list of media contacts. That has a $20 price tag. And they're offered the ability to have a secret system to get on national television in the LA market if they fit certain conditions and criteria of the type of business they have. Yes, the very best part, Evan, is that out of every 5 sales that take place of those ideas, then somebody buys a media release, professional written media release from me, and now we're talking a few $100.
That's great. Hey, Mark, this is tons of information. Thank you so much. If people want to learn more about you and maybe even order that service, it sounds great, where can they go?
They can go to Fiverr.com/anarcho-fighter. That's ANARCHOFIGHTER, and see all of the offerings there.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Mark. Hey, if I have more questions, maybe I'll have you on as a repeat guest.
Love to be here.
All right. Appreciate it. What I really love about Fiverr, for those of you guys listening, is it basically does the marketing for you, right? One of the hardest parts about running a business is getting customers, getting leads. And so Fiverr gives you the option to be able to get new leads to your business, drive new traffic, and then you can upsell them on all the different things that you have to offer. And as you heard, you can go all the way up to $500 on a sale, and Mark bought a house from it. So there's a lot of opportunities. I think I'm going to have to log back into my account and see what else I can do on Fiverr. It's definitely an inspirational talk, and I really appreciate Mark coming on. If you guys liked him, let me know, and maybe we'll have him on as a repeat guest. How do you make $1 million? That's the $1 million question. One of my YouTube viewers, Guy, asked me, Evan, I want to make $1 million within 20 years. I have $20,000 in savings, and let's assume I have no education. I have education, let's assume I don't. I made a video reply. I said, Guy, listen, why do you have to wait 20 years? You could do this so much faster. The key, and for you guys, loyal listeners, you know my message. You have to start a business around your passion and something that helps people. You want to make money, you have to help people. You want to make lots of money, you got to help people a lot and do something that you love to do. I think back to the first call of the show, we had Kiki who talked about her laundromat. That's not the $1 million idea. She doesn't love that business. She's moving on to designing fashion, designing clothes. That's what she loves. There's an opportunity there. If you are starting a business, you have to do it around something that you love doing and something that helps a lot of people. As for the other things, hey, it doesn't matter how much money you're starting up with. I don't care if you have $20,000 in the bank, zero in the bank, $100,000 in the bank. It doesn't matter. You don't need money to make money. You need hustle. You need drive. You need passion. You need customers. You have to listen to them. You got to get out there. It's never about how many resources you have. It's how resourceful you are. And education for most businesses doesn't matter. Nobody asked me what my education is. I have an undergrad, a bachelor's degree from the University of Toronto, Commerce and Finance, but nobody asked me that. When you call in and ask me questions to your business, you say, listen, I want to know what your education is before you answer my question. In most businesses, it doesn't matter. Now, if you're a doctor, I probably don't want to go to a doctor who didn't graduate high school. Okay? But otherwise, it doesn't really matter. And I know a lot of entrepreneurs who feel like their lack of an education and their lack of startup capital hold them back. And as long as you tell yourself that story, it will hold you back. It's just in your head. If you look at the most successful, most famous entrepreneurs in the world, most of them started with nothing. No money. Some had an education, but it doesn't matter. Don't let those things hold you back. You have to build a business around your passion. I want to get to the calls. We got time for one more caller. I have Chantel on the line. Chantel, where are you from? How can I help?
I live in Texas 2 years now. I'm a singer looking to open up a lot of businesses with no money. My music is going great at home, but the only thing is I'm in Houston, Texas. I want to do a nonprofit business, and I'm finding it hard, and I want to know how can I get that going with no money and keep the IRS away from me so much.
Keep the IRS away from you. Hey, come on. Okay, hold on. What is the main business you want to start? Is it your singing? Is it the nonprofit? Is it something else? What's the main focus here?
Because of my father, he's a minister, I'm on a roll right now with the nonprofit.
Okay, and what does it do?
I'm looking to go get young girls and women who are abused in every way possible, who have children, single and struggling, like myself with my daughter. I chose nonprofit because it's a music ministry, and that fits in with my singing. My daughter is a model and a dancer.
So what is it? What do you do? So that's who you help. What do you actually do for them?
Well, I want to help change their lives as far as getting resources for them, to bring them to church for a better life, to help them with education, get whatever resource I can find for them. If they're in the streets, get them off the streets, get them in a house, get them protected, you know, like that, to give back to the community as far as music.
Is this a new thing for you?
Yes, it's very new.
Okay, so this is great. I love the cause. I feel like it ties into something you're really passionate about, so it's awesome. You may have a focus issue.
Yes.
But let's leave that one alone for now.
Okay.
So when you're out and trying to promote this and you're trying to get partners and you're trying to get support, you have to be really clear in your pitch and what it is that you're offering. Right, so you don't want to go out and say, hey, I'm trying to get everything I can to help these people. You want to have a really clear program that people can get behind.
Okay, so how do I avoid the guys who, excuse it, I don't want to hit the airwaves the wrong way, but who are the horny toads, and I can get the money, but I have to do some weird favor for it. How do I avoid that? So I lose my opportunity, but I'm not going to turn over a pillow for the opportunity.
You know what? If you're taking money, you have to feel right about it. You don't want to just take money for money and it comes with all these, you know, strings attached.
Exactly.
You got to feel right about the money you're taking. So people are joining your organization. If they're sponsors, donors, mentors, I don't know. Like, there's got to be lots of people you need to get this thing to go. You have to do your screening.
Okay.
Right? The companies that are getting involved, the mentors getting involved, they have to be in it for the right reason.
That's right.
And you need to
How do I go to them?
What? What's that?
How do I go to them? The sponsors.
Well, it starts with a pitch. Like, what do you do?
Music. Hey, I'm a recording artist.
No, I know that you're a recording artist, but what does your organization do? Right? You came in and said, well, we try to provide as much resources as possible for these women.
Yes.
You need
yes.
to have a clear program.
Okay.
Right? People have, they're committed all over the place. Their money and time are going to lots of different places. So to stand out, to make them say, hey, I want to work with Chantel, then you got to convince them. You need to have a passionate plea to say why you started this business and what you're going to offer.
Okay.
So a clear program, like, what are you doing, why, and how is it going to help these girls? And it doesn't have to be far-ranging, right? Sometimes if it's too big, you get lost, and people can't wrap their head around it. It might just be connecting, you know, abused women with mentors to help guide them through the struggle and the process they face with their daily lives. Maybe that's how
you start. That's exactly what it is.
All right, we just got your pitch.
Thank you.
Whatever, that's it, or if another aspect, if it's getting them homes, or if it's just bringing them to the church and making them feel part of the community, whatever it is, like, pick one thing to start with, make it crystal clear, and get people to understand what it is that you do.
Okay.
Okay, you got some homework.
I do. I'm going to get started ASAP, so
okay.
I know you
okay.
help me
hey,
make it clear.
Know, I'm on every 2 weeks. If you want to call back and we'll work through your pitch and you can rock me
awesome.
With your new pitch, let me know, okay?
Oh, awesome. I sure will.
Okay, thanks, Chantel. We'll talk
thanks
to you.
Thank you. Okay, bye.
So for everybody listening, it's the same issue we're dealing earlier. You know, you got to have a clear pitch. When we're talking to our Whig friend, you got to know what you're selling, how you stand out, if you want people to be able to talk about you and understand it. Hey, that's it. We're done for the day. Time flies. It's crazy. Thank you so much. You can follow me on Twitter, Evan Carmichael. Check out the website, evancarmichael.com. I want to thank my producers, Zach and Courtney. You guys rocked it, as usual. I will see you guys all in 2 weeks. Stay tuned. Have a great couple weeks. Good luck, guys. Talk to you soon.